Hi, welcome to a calculator tutorial from Equaser. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this video, we are going to learn about converting polar and rectangular coordinates using Texas Instruments TI-84 Plus CE Python Edition. This video is part of a full video of TI-84 Plus CE Python Edition. Link is below this video. I'm turning on the calculator. For some reason, if you press window and you're stuck, you can press second function and quit to exit from the screen. Now let's set our calculators to default so we have the same settings. Press second function, mem, and follow the screen. 7, 2, and then 2, reset, press clear. First, let's change the angle unit, because most of the time you will work with degree unless you want radian. So press mode, go once and twice until you see radian is blinking. This is degree, press enter and clear. Now you see degree on the screen, but we can change it the same way that I have just shown. So we have polar, and for rectangular, some schools or books use the term Cartesian. So get ready for this new term as well. Now, example one, we have R and we have theta. We want to convert it to rectangular when we want to find the coordinate of this point, which is X and Y. Now to get started with that, press second function and then angle. And here we have the value. It is polar when we want rectangular, X. Press 7. We see this on the screen. And we enter the R and then theta. 6 and then comma. We have to separate them with comma and then 37. Remember, we are assuming this is degree, but regardless, the result will be here. Then press enter, and now this says get X, and this is our X value. We entered R and theta. This is a polar, and we got rectangular value for X. To remind you here that when I press second function and angle, for example, I want to get X, and this screen, you can press plus symbol, plus sign, and the help will appear here, which means enter R, comma, and theta, which you can continue here. 6, comma, 37, enter. This will come and help you, and then you can enter to get the result. And now, let's get the angle, second function, angle. This time press 8 because we want to get Y, and the same way, let's enter 6, comma, 37, and we don't need to close it unless you want to use it in other calculation. It can work without closing, as I shown before. And so this is our Y value, so we converted polar to rectangular. And now let's have an example in radian. R is 6, theta is pi over 4. As you can see here, we want to get X, and this is in radian. Now let's see how we can invert it. As I mentioned, our unit is degree. And now let's get X, second function, angle, 7 to get X. And now enter 6 as before. 6, comma, second function, pi. For pi, we press this button and then bring the fraction over 4. With the arrow, we have to go to the right. And now let's bring R here for radian, because we have to mention this is radian. So second function, angle, and the number 3, R. Close it and enter. We got 4.2426. That is value for X. Now, let's get y, second function, angle, and then 8. Now it's y, and then 6, comma, alpha, pi. Second function, pi, and then alpha fraction over 4 with the arrow go to the right. It's important. And again, we have to bring r here, second function, angle 3, that's r, close it and enter. And as you can see, for x and y, we got 4.2426 because the angle is pi over 4, this is 45 degrees, so the x and y must have the same value. Now, example number 2, we have x and y. And we want to get theta and r, the magnitude or length of this vector. So r and theta are needed. And we will get, we have x, you see x is minus 5. This is a below x-axis and x is 4. Now, let's press second function, angle. This time press 5 to get r. It says rectangular to polar r. R is x is 4 and then comma, and then we have to enter y. For minus 5 we press this minus at the bottom and then 5, enter. So we got the r value because here it says get r. So this is our r. And let's do the theta, second function, angle. This time 6 for it says rectangular to polar, get theta, 4, comma, minus 5, enter. So the angle is now minus 51. So this is our angle, minus 51 degrees. And as you can see, the angle is below x-axis, minus 51 makes sense, so the answer is correct. Now we have this theta, 50 degrees, and then r, 6, we want to find x and y. So this 50 degrees that you see here is not 50 degrees that you will enter in calculator because we have first quadrant 90 degrees and then 90 degrees and then 50. So we have to add them all together before entering it. So our angle is now 230 degrees, second function, angle 7, we want x first, and r is 6, comma, and our theta is 230. Here we can enter the expression, remember it was 90 plus 90 plus 50, we could do that, and we got x minus 3.85. And now let's get y, second function, angle. Now I'm pressing 8, 6, comma. Now let's enter 230. And we got the y value here because it says r, polar to rectangular, get y. Polar to rectangular, get x. And as you can see here, because the x is minus 3.8, it's on the left side, and y is also below the x-axis, minus, so our answer is correct. Thanks for watching. Please thumb up the video, and also please don't forget to subscribe.